come on in to Married at First Sight, Season 16, Episode 12. And my name is Deborah, and I'm going to be doing individual recaps on all the individual couples. So be sure to drop down in the comments, like, subscribe, and comment on this video. And at the end of this video, check out above my head. There'll be links to all the individual videos, and you can watch them all. And now we're moving on to Chris and Nicole. And let me tell you, they invited Nicole's dad back on the show, Nicole 2.0. Nicole is a spin image of her daddy. He a takeover type of person too. That's why when he was giving Chris all that advice about you gonna need big D energy, he was giving that advice because he knows that's what people need to deal with him too. He was projecting. He was basically saying, you gonna need big D energy because my daughter is just like me and I'm a takeover. They went over here and did this goat yoga, and you hear the whole story about, well, how did you guys get into goat yoga, doing goat yoga together? And Nicole told the story, well, actually, I was the one that invited my dad. But after I invited him, next thing you know, he's teaching classes, teaching at the university. He done took it all over. He taking it to a whole nother level. That's the takeover spirit. You invite them in, next thing you know, they taking over the whole thing. That's Nicole. Nicole gets her exact personality from her daddy. But here's the problem. Nicole's the female. So she came in with the spirit of her father, which is more male energy. And now she's telling Chris that he's too wimpy. He needs a big D energy. No, no. You got lots of male energy because you got it from your daddy. That's fine. But now Chris needs to be even more than you. Then what would he be? What would he be? If you got the male energy, what he's supposed to be? A giant, an Amazon? What new level he got to go to? He got to go past male energy? He got to go way beyond that? No, no, Nicole. You got your energy from your daddy, which now I can understand how she probably got into problems in her previous relationships. I really do see how Nicole got where she was in previous relationships, because a lot of men would not like this energy she brings, would not like the energy her dad brings to a relationship because she's a female. So I could see how she probably got into problems in relationships. I can also see why she attracted the man she did, because who else can put up with this energy except a man who's very, very strong. And like I've told you, when you get men who are very, very strong, those men get strong two different types of ways. Some men are very, very strong because that's what they like to do. They like to hunt, devour, throw away, destroy. Some men are strong, but they're nice men. But the problem when all you do is attract really strong men is a lot of times you attract toxic strong men, because a lot of men became strong because of negative situations. So that strong energy you're getting from them isn't good. That's why when I'm talking about, they want men who hunt them. Be careful of why men are hunting women, because some men hunt women very strong because their appetites are insatiable. So as a result, no woman ever satisfies them. So they've learned to hunt really well because they have to do a lot of it because they're running through women. But a lot of women always look at that as, oh, it's all a positive. No, don't always look at it a positive. You better find out why he has such strong hunter instincts, because sometimes it comes from negative places. And what happened to Nicole is she has probably been attracting real strong men because of all the strong energy she gives off. And she attracts men who want to come in and put her in her place and dominate her. That's what she's been attracting. And what she said was her stuff has been so toxic that when other men come along, like men who've come along like Chris, she's pushed them away. You know why? Because she realized she would have to do work. She would have to calm down. So instead of accepting the Chris's, she pushed them away. But now here she is married to one of them. And you know what she's trying to make him do? Change. She's trying to turn him into the very man that used to abuse her. No, no, that's not the solution. That's why I'm going to push back on this whole thing that Chris needs big D energy. No, he doesn't. Not when he's dealing with a person like Nicole. Because the more energy, big D energy, that Chris gets, you know what Nicole will do? She'll ratchet her stuff up. Because what she does is, if you can go here, that means I can keep coming up here. And then what she'll keep telling you is, you need more energy. Because what she wants to do is she wants to keep ramping it up. She wants to do like her father. She wants to have a takeover spirit. So the way she gets to let loose is for you to be able to take her stuff. So she wants you, no, 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 cap it, Chris. say, I'm not going to have no more BDE. I'm going to stay right here. And it's not going to be my job to keep ramping it up so you can keep ramping it up. What I'm going to do is stay right here, and you're going to need to learn how to ramp your stuff down. Push back on it, Chris. Push back on that stuff that father is saying, and push back on that stuff that she's saying, because that's their strategy in life. They want everybody to have big D energy so they can deal with them. No, that's not our work to do. It's your work to tone that stuff down. Tone it down. But in the end, you know what? Her father realized Chris is really good for her. Chris is really good for her. And he even said, you know what? Now you can start calling me daddy, and I'm going to call you son. I really like that. I really like the blessing of the father on the marriage, because, of course, he wasn't able to give it because it was married at first sight, marrying a stranger. So I was happy to see that he feels comfortable enough with Chris, and Chris feels comfortable enough with him, that they now could be a father and son. I really did enjoy that. The father was like, I thought it was going to take 8 weeks, but here we are. Here we are. It's soon, better later than never. Here we are already, sooner than I thought. So it also tells you that the father also has a nice soft side to him as well. He has his strong exterior, but on the inside, he has a soft side. Like I said, it's really Nicole, because Nicole, it really is a sweet person too. She got that takeover spirit, but she's also a nice person. That's what's blending with Chris really well, is her nice side. So she shouldn't be encouraging Chris to bring out his negative side so she can keep ramping up the negative. No, stay in that nice side of you, Nicole. That's where your happiness is going to be. That's where her happiness, her long-term happiness is going to be. But the one thing about Nicole, as opposed to some of the other couples, is she does have a bit more emotional intelligence. She is starting to realize that, some of her past relationships have played a bigger part in this relationship more than she thought it would. And so that means she's going to think about it, which means she's going to put a little bit more effort forward for it, which I appreciate that. And so I think that's going to help build the intimacy that Dr. Pepper talked about with them. I still feel really strong about these two. I think they're going to make it. I think their conversation is good. I think they have a good system through working through things. Really, really, I do. I think they work through their problems really, really well. I know Nicole is really afraid that if a shoe's going to drop, what's going to happen when they have their first big fight, their first big disagreement, and she's afraid that it's all going to fall apart, that it's too good to be true. But I think if they keep with their system that they have here, and that is being calm when they discuss things, being empathetic when they talk about things, I think they'll be able to work through their problems. That's why I say don't be encouraging this big D energy, because if he brings that energy into an argument, that's not going to serve it well. His calm nature right now is what's allowing them to work through their issues, because they have had issues, but they haven't blown up, and they haven't blown up because of the way that Chris shows up. If he is showing up with big D energy, guess what? These problems may not get solved this way. She thinks they haven't had any issues, but they have had issues. What hasn't happened is they haven't blown up because they've been able to solve them. But I still feel very strongly about these two. But that's it, y'all. Be sure to like and subscribe to my videos, and watch the other videos here with the couples. The links are here. Talk to you later. Bye.